know, my name is Geeta Chowk. Today I will show you one problem on this LG smart inverter refrigerator. So this refrigerator has a problem regarding with completely power problem, right? So we will see how to trace and how to resolve the problem, okay? Provide power. So for the first time we will have to see indicator, right? But right now there is no indicator lights this time, okay? So there is no power. So let's check. Press one times to make it functional of the compressor, LEDs and the freezer fan. But right now, even if I just press this, still now the compressor is not start, even the fan is not start. So now we will see how to trace the power supply and the boards, right? So we have to start from the power supply section, right? Maybe the problem will be at the power supply. Okay, now I just prepare this circuit diagram, right? This power supply is for the switch mode power supply only. From except the power supply, we will have the next chapter. So now for the first time, I just prepare only power supply circuit diagram and how to trace and how to resolve the problem using this diagram, right? So we will starting from the cable, right? Maybe the problem will be at the power cable. We have to set our multimeter at the continuity, and you have to clearly and make sure that your multimeter will give the continuity. So we have to make sure. Okay, right. So the next is given for the next. So this point directly goes to at this part, right? Once goes to this, and the next goes to at this part, right? Okay, the power that the cable is normal, and again we will use a cold test. So for the power line, for the phase line, we will see a fuse, right? The fuse is directly placed at these parts. So the fuse is directly connected. The next fuse is directly connected to the inductor. The next fuse is directly connected to the inductor. So we will have inductor from this part, this point to this, and from this to this, right? Now we are seeing, okay, we are seeing this part, right? Goes to these parts and directly connected to the inductor. The inductor is now given a continuity, so it means normal, right? The output of inductor is directly goes to the output of inductor. The output of inductor is directly goes to at the OLP. The output of the OLP is directly goes to the rectifier points. So now we are now at this part, right? The output of inductor is directly goes to this part. This part is jumper. Right, the jumper point is directly goes to the NTC. The NTC directly goes to the OLP, right? You will see a mark here, OLP points, right? There is written things that is OLP, right? So OLP is directly connected at this part. Okay, so the OLP should give a continuity, right? Now we are touch these parts, so the OLP is not given a continuity, so maybe the problem will be at the OLP. Maybe it's not connected. So as we see, at least the OLP is connected, right? So the OLP is not given a continuity. So the rectifier will not receive 220 voltage, right? We will have 220 voltage at this part, but we will not have 220 voltage. So the rectifier will not receive 200 voltage. If the rectifier will not receive the 220 voltage, the rest circuit will not work, right? Because they didn't receive any voltage, any power. Let's check the second things, right? So what we are expected, the one terminal, this means the one terminal, the first terminal directly gives the continuity up to other rectifier point, right? Again, we will see continuity from neutral to other rectifier because it is completely line and it's also completely line, right? So next, the first one, we are expected a continuity up to here, right? Because we are receiving continuity. If the OLP gives a continuity, we will see a continuity, right? So there is an open circuit between these two terminals. And the next one, the neutral terminal directly goes to the inductor. The inductor output will be directly goes to the... This terminal is directly goes to this terminal, right? Because there is a copper plate to the front side, right? Now we are receiving one terminal, the continuity. This is a rectifier. This is a rectifier. That is, the input is AC, the output will be DC. The one terminal is not given. The next terminal will give continuity. That's okay, this is the part for the OLP connector. So we will have OLP at this part. You have to remove the cover of the OLP. So you will have an OLP, right? So maybe the OLP is defective. So let's remove and let's check. But before that, you have to make sure maybe the problem is at the cable, right? So we will see the functionality of the OLP cable. So now you just remove these things. You just remove these things, right? Because you are not comfortable to measure continuity, or your multimeter will not insert it properly if you are not remove these things, these parts. So make sure the multimeter is set at the continuity. Okay, we will see, we will check the functionality of the cable. Okay, the one cable is normal. So both the cable are normal. So the problem may be at the OLP. Okay, the OLP is not given a continuity. So this time the OLP is defective, right? But now at room temperature it should give continuity sound. So we will replace this OLP according to the specification, right? Okay, so now this is defective, so we have to replace with a new OLP, right? So I just have the new one. So let's check the functionality of the OLP, right? Okay, now it gives a continuity, so this is functional. So you have to place the OLP. Okay, so now we are replacing the new OLP, right? But we have to clearly sure what is the problem that OLP can be defective, right? This OLP is directly placed at the 120 line, right? One, the problem will be maybe because of the overcurrent in the power supply circuit, and maybe the OLP can be defective because of overheated, the compressor overheated, right? So let's check the functionality of the compressor. Maybe this OLP can be defective because of the compressor. If the compressor is defective, the compressor become overheated and the OLP become overheated, and continuously the OLP become open, right? So let's check the functionality of the compressor. So set your multimeter at the ohmic resistance value and remove the connector. Carefully, you have to remove this connector. Okay, measure the resistance value, then you will see from 11 ohms around 12 and 13 ohms, right? Each point. So change the point. You will see the same resistance value each. And you will see same resistance. So this is a compressor winding U, V and W, right? So from U to V, we will see from 11 to 13 ohm. The same thing from U to W, we will see 11 to 13 ohm. From V to W, we'll see 11 to 13 ohm, right? So now we are just measure the compressor. So compressor winding is normal, right? Because we are just already seen a normal resistance value. So the OLP can be defective because of maybe because of surge current on the power supply section, right? Okay, now we are replace the new OLP. Let's see the functionality, right? Previously, we are seeing the fuse, the output fuse, inductor output, jumper output, NTC output, OLP input, OLP output. So now we are already seeing from the input phase terminal to the rectifier input, right? And neutral also from the neutral AC input to the rectifier input, right? So now let's measure the board by using the hottest, right? So now plug in the power and measure voltage in between. Okay, first set your multimeter at AC voltage, right? Set the voltage at the AC selector and measure voltage between phase terminal and neutral terminal. Then you will see 220 voltage. Then measure voltage between fuse output, right? If the fuse become defective, you will not see output of 220 voltage, right? Again, measure voltage in between inductor, right? You will see 220 voltage. And measure voltage, the output of the inductor. If the inductor will defective, you will not see this output voltage, right? Then you will go to at this part, right? And go to the jumper. If the jumper is normal, you will see output voltage, right? And you will go to at the NTC. If the NTC is normal, you will see output. And you will go to at the OLP points. If the OLP become normal, you will see output voltage. If the OLP is not normal, you will not see output, right? And this voltage directly goes to this point. This voltage is directly goes to this point, right? This voltage directly goes to at the rectifier, and this voltage is directly goes to at the rectifier. So now we are, our rectifier is now receiving 220 voltage, so you will see output from the rectifier, right? So you will see a mark, the plus terminal and minus terminal. So you have to make sure your multimeter probe is directly placed to the plus terminal, directly connected to the red, the minus terminal directly connected to the minus. So you will see output voltage from the rectifier. Previously, the OLP is not working, so the rectifier is not receiving 220 voltage, so the rectifier will not give this output voltage, right? So let's convert the board and let's turn the board and let's see the LED indicator. So you have to remove the So now I just provide power. So now we are seeing an indicator, right? Previously we are not seeing these things, right? Okay, now to make it functional, the compressor, the fan and the LEDs, press one times the test button. So now the compressor is now start. So we will see the fan and the LED become working. So the fan is now start, right? The fan is now working. Now we are repairing this refrigerator. So the problem is OLP. Sometimes OLP can be defective. Sometimes this refrigerator becomes completely absence of power because of OLP and some other things, right? So we understand the board part, right? In order to identify and in order to maintain and repair the product. Okay, thank you.